Hi everyone, let's see how to set up Visual Studio Code IDE for working on Qt 6 application with Visual Studio Compiler or Debugger. I've set up a small project for that. So the first thing I'm doing is to set up my environment. So I want to work with Visual Studio 2022 and I want to work with Qt 6. And here I am. You can see Qt is set up on my environment. Now I need to start Visual Studio Code. So generally what you would do is code dot to open the current directory, but I'm adding a bit more things here to start with a virgin Visual Studio Code, meaning that there are no extensions installed for me. Project is starting and yes, I'm trusting the author. And you can see some pop-up at the bottom. And this one is asking you to install some recommended extensions from Microsoft and TWXS. So just install because there are three extensions. First one is the official Microsoft C++ extension for compiling and debugging. The second one is the one that allows you to open a CMake project. And the last one gives you some syntax highlighting for CMakes. Okay, project extensions are loaded. So now what I can do is actually compile the project. So I'm pressing F7 and it's asking, do we want to use the debug release or profile setup preset? Sorry, let's use the debug one. Compilation is done and now F5 to start the project and boom, the application is displayed. It's working. How does it work now? The first thing you need in the project is a CMake preset.json. That's the file that defines the different presets. So debug, release, and profile for me, where you can see I set up a CMake build type here. And this button allows you to change the current preset. So you can move from debug to release or to profile. Very, very nice to share your setup with your colleagues. And then you have files in the .vs code directory. So the first one allows you to set up the include path, the Qt include path. So it's using this thing, Qtdir. Qtdir is actually an environment variable. So if I'm showing you here, Qtdir is set up on the console. And it's picked up here to find the current include files for Qt. That's the thing that allows you to open the Qt widget, but also to have code completion for all the Qt API. The second one, we saw this one. It's the one that gives you some recommended extensions. And the next one is very important also because it gives all the configuration for debugging or running the application. So the program that is going to be run is this one. It's resolved by CMake tools. So that's the target here. In this current project, there's only one target, but in different projects, you may have multiple targets and you can change the target here. This line here is also very important for debugging because it allows you to say to a debugger how to display specific variable, like for example a qstring. What you want to display in the debugger is the text of a qstring. If you don't have a .vs file, then you will display the raw data, which is very hard to figure out. With this, it will display the string directly. And finally, both lines define the mapping between the path in the library and the path on your computer, allowing you to basically debug inside Qt code. So for example here, if I'm putting a breakpoint, I can obviously debug my own code, but I can also go inside the Qt code and debug inside Qt. And that's it. That's what you need for setting up Visual Studio Code IDE. If you start on a deployment project, what you need to do is copy the CMake preset, the JSON, the Qt6.NATVS, and these two files here. you don't need to copy the extensions or settings because extensions will be already installed and the settings will be recreated by Visual Studio Code. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you very much for listening.